Hello all, welcome back to the module 4 of digital system design, and we are in the last part of the module 4. As I said, we will go ahead with the sequential circuits or the networks. So if you remember, during the starting of the module 4, I had specified we will go through the sequential networks or the sequential circuits. So wherein we have two types of sequential circuits or networks. One is the Mealy sequential network and another is the Moore sequential network. So in simple, they are called as Moore machine and Mealy machine. Okay, so there is a difference. So what is a Moore machine? Okay, so the definition of Moore machine is, in the Moore machine or in the Moore sequential network or a circuit, outputs are function solely of the current state. Okay, so output depends only on the current state. Okay, so output changes synchronously with the state changes. The moment any state changes, then the output changes. Okay, in synchronous with them, and outputs are solely function of the current state. If I want to see the block diagram of Moore machine, is this is something like that. Okay, so I have an inputs. We have the next state combination logic, then we have a state register, then we have an output combination logic, and the state register output not only goes to the input of output combination logic, but also is fed back to the combinational logic. So this next state combinational logic has both input as well as the states. Okay, that will give us the next state, and in which finally we go to the output combinational logic, and output is what we are getting from the Moore machine. Okay, so the Moore machine, in definition, in which the outputs are function solely of the current state. That is what we mean by, and output changes synchronously with the state changes. And coming to the Mealy machine, okay, you can see only one change is there between the Moore and the Mealy. Okay, you can say that output combinational logic is getting the input from the state register, which will give us the present state. Okay, whereas if I see the Mealy machine, it is a combination of Moore plus one extra thing is there. Okay, so the output combinational logic not only gets the input from the state register output, but it also gets the inputs from the external. Okay, or in other words, I can define the Mealy machine as something like this. Mealy machine, in which the outputs depend on state as well as on the inputs, present inputs. Okay, that is the difference between a Mealy and the Moore. In Moore machine, output was depending solely on the states, that is the current state, but Mealy machine, those outputs depend both on the current state as well as the present inputs. Okay, this is the difference. And asynchronous signals, input change causes an immediate output change. Okay, so this is what. So here, the output changes with respect to the input change. That is the thing that we have. Okay, so this is about the Mealy and the Moore sequential network. And we'll try to see the examples of Moore and the Mealy. So till now, we discussed in this particular session the sequential circuit or the network. This is divided into two categories. One is the Mealy and another is the Moore. In short, we call Moore machine and Mealy machine. In Moore, the output depends only on the current state, whereas in the Mealy machine, the output not only depends upon the current states, but also depends on the present inputs or the current inputs. Okay, so this is what we have. And in the Moore, output is in synchronous with the state, whereas in Mealy, output is in synchronous with the input change. So that's a difference that we have between this. And anyhow, we will make it very clear how this Moore and Mealy works in the next set of slides. Okay. And before going to the machines, that is the Moore and the Mealy, we are having some of the notation that has to be followed. Okay. So state machine notations. Okay. So we should know first what is an input variable. All variables that originate outside the sequential machines are said to be input variables. Okay, so the machine that gets the input outside, from outside, that we call it as something like an input variable. Okay, all variables that originate outside the sequential machines are said to be input variable, output variables. All variables that exit the sequential machines are said to be output variables. Okay, the signals that are coming out of the sequential machine, we call them as a output variables. Then state variable, the output of the memory, that is the flip flops, defines the state of a sequential machine. State variables are the flip flop outputs. Okay, if I use two flip flops, then I will have two state. Okay, so that's what. If I have one flip flop, so you can see here, the output of the memory flip flop defines the state of a sequential machine. If I have one flip flop, and if the value of that flip flop or the value stores zero means it is in one state. If it stores one means it is in the other state. So state variables are the flip flop outputs. If I have two flip flops, I get four states: 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. This is what we mean by the state variable. Excitation variable. Excitation variable are the inputs to memory. Okay, that means the flip-flop will change its states depending upon the inputs, and that inputs we call it as an excitation variable. And then the state. The state of a sequential machine is defined by the content of the memory. That is the content of the flip-flop. If I have two flip-flops, and if the content of both the flip-flops is 0, 0, then I will say that it is a zero state. Okay, that is what we mean by, okay. So state variable, we give a name for that, where a state is in which particular state the memory is in. This is the thing that we have. Then present state, the status of all the state variables at some time t before the next clock edge represents the present state. So what is the present state? The status of all the state variables at some time t before the next clock edge comes. That is what we mean by the present state. All variables that originate outside the sequential machines are said to be input variables. Okay, we have already seen what is an input variable previously. Okay, next state. The status of all the status variables at some time t plus 1 represents a condition and called next state. T plus 1 means after the time clock, after the clock. Present state is the status of all the state variables before the clock comes, whereas next state is the status of all the state variables after the clock pulse. Before the clock, if it is t, means after the clock it will be t plus 1. That is the difference between the next state and the present state. State diagram, next, is the graphical representation of the state machine or the sequential circuit. And we have already seen the state diagram with respect to the states and how exactly the flow goes. We can also see in the next slides what is the state diagram and all. Okay, so this is the state diagram. Is the graphical representation of the state machine or the sequential circuit. So now we'll see here two examples. One, the JK flip-flop, and the other is the SR flip-flop. So we tried to first define Mealy state machine. In Mealy state machine, how JK flip-flop can be defined, and in Moore state machine, how JK flip-flop can be defined. Okay, so this is what the first figure what you are seeing, okay, is the Mealy. Okay, this is the Mealy state machine. Okay, and the second figure what you are seeing is the Moore sequential machine or a Moore state machine. Okay, so this is what we mean by the state machine. Okay, we have already defined what is a state machine in the previous slide. Okay, we'll see how exactly for a JK flip-flop the state machine in terms of Mealy and Moore looks like. Okay, so now we have two things here. Okay, I have defined two states. One state is A, this is one state, and that state variable I call it as a A. This is state one, and this I have one more state, and that I call it as something like two. Okay, as state 1, the variable name I have given is A, and state 2, the variable name I have given is B. Okay, this is what is really all about. Okay, so when I take any flip-flop, and in this case JK flip-flop, my flip-flop will be either, it will be set, or it will be cleared. That means, in other words, I can say JK flip-flop either can store 1, which we call it as set, or store 0, which we call it as clear or reset, whatever. Okay. So state A, we call it as something like the zero state of the JK flip-flop. State B as the one state of the flip-flop, that is a set state. Okay. So assuming that I am in state 1, that is A, okay, I can be in any states. I can be in state A or I can be in state B. Okay, so I'll try to define here. Okay, so if suppose I am in state A, I'm just rewriting the state Mealy state machine. Okay, for our understanding, okay, how exactly we got this particular Mealy state machine. Okay, assume that if I'm in state 1, that is A, okay, and based on the inputs and the present state. Okay. So JK now forms the inputs for me. Okay. JK now forms the inputs. Okay. Plus the present state. And you should remember that Mealy state machine is the sequential machine in which its output depend both on the present input as well as on the present state. Okay. And that's why we are defining the present input in terms of J and K, because we are writing a Mealy state machine for JK plus the present state. Okay. So which is my present state? I'm in present state A. Okay. When I'm in present state A, okay, then the depending the value of JK. Okay. When I say J and K, two variables, I can give four combinations, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. Suppose if J and K are 0 and 1, and I am ensuring that state 1 is a state variable A, and this is something like, this state I define as something like a 0 state. Okay, this is a 0 state. Okay, so I am in the present state, and the present state value is 0, and if my JK inputs are 0, 1, okay, and now you should see the characteristic table or the truth table of the JK flip-flop. Okay, so sorry, I'll just go with 0, 1, 0, 0, first value of JK. Okay, so I know that characteristic table. I will write the characteristic table of JK here for our understanding. Okay, JK flip-flop, J and K, and this is my next state output. Okay, when it is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. So when it is 0, 0, it is previous. Okay. When it is 0, 1, it is 0. When it is 1, 0, it is 1. When it is 1, 1, it is the previous bar. Okay. This is what we have, the characteristic table or the truth table. Okay. So based on this only, we'll try to assign. So now I'm in state A, and state A, I represent it as something like a 0 state. Okay. So this is my present state. That means I have assumed my present state something to be 0. Okay. And what are my inputs? 0, 0. And when both J and K are 0, 0, my next state will be the same as the present state. Yes. So when I'm in present state A, and that I have defined it as 0, and if I get the inputs J and K are 0, 0, I should return, and my next state should be the same as the present state with the output 0. Why zero? Because this is what I mean by the zero. Or there is no change in the output of that particular flip-flop. Okay. So I have defined state A to be a zero state. Okay. My present state is zero, and the present inputs are zero, zero. And I know that when J and K are both zero, zero, my next state will be the same as the present state. Okay. If I am, my present state is A, which is zero, the next state also to be same, and in which my output is zero. Why zero? Because I mean the present state is zero, so that way the next state is also zero. So in this way, I can say that this is the output of JK flip-flop that depends upon the inputs as well as on the state gate. Okay, this is next coming to the 0, 1. Okay, I'm in again state A, and I call it as something like zero state, and instead of 0, 1, I get 0 and 1 now. Okay, so instead of writing there, I write here. Instead of 0, 0, I'm getting the inputs as 0 and 1. When I have J0 and K1, what is my next state? Next state should be, that is the output should be simply 0. And which is that next state that is simply 0? And I have said that A is a state with 0 value, and that's why I have written in the same state. Okay. So when 0, 0, I will be in the same state. And in 0, 1 also, I will be in the same state. Only reason is I am considering this state to be 0. Now, the third case. I am getting the third case as 1 and 0. When J is 1 and K is 0, and if I am in state A, which is nothing but what state 0, when I give the values 1 and 0, irrespective of which state I am, my next state should be changed. Yes? State A is representing A means when it is 1, 0, if I am in state A, which I call it as 0 state, now I have to move to some other state because my output is changing from 0 to 1. So that's why I go from state A to B, which I call it as the second state, state 2. And this state 2, I call it as state as one state. Is it okay? That's easy for us to understand this. Okay? So when it is 1, 0, and if I'm present in the state A, J1, J0, and if I'm in state A, my output becomes 1 and I have to move to the next state. That's what. Okay? This is what. This is one case. If not 1, 0, if it is 1, 1, if I'm in state A and that state is 0, my next state is what? Complement, and my output is complement of the previous. The presence, this is my 0, the output becomes 1, and also I should move to the next state, that is B state, which is nothing but what? State 1. This is the complete thing. Okay. So we have, if I'm in state A, and state A I have considered it as a 0 state. That is no change. Okay. Something like that. State B is state 2, which I call it as a state 1. I mean, one state. Okay. So if I'm in state 1, state A, sorry, depending upon the inputs and in which present state I am in, my output changes. When JK 0, 0 and my present state is A minus, and this A is a 0 state, I'll retain in the same state by letting the output 0. Same case holds good with 0, 1. But when it is 1, 0, my output changes. I move from present state to the next state, which is B. If it is 1, 0 or 1. Now again, the condition with respect to A is over. Now I am in state B. Assume that I'm in state B. Again, I will get four condition. Okay. One condition is 0, 0. Okay. Now, my present state is B, which is a state 1. And my inputs are 0, 0. When JK are 0, 0, what is my next state? Same state. That's why I retain in the same state with output as 1. You can see that. Why? Because state B is a 1 state whose output is not changing. That's one. If not 0, 0, if it is... If not 0, 0, if it is 0, 1, I am in state B, which I call it as 1 state, but I've got J0, K1. So what is happening to my output? Output is changing. When the output is changing to 0, means which is the 0 state? That is A. I have to move from this to this now. Okay, 0, 1. Next is 1, 0. Assuming that I'm in state B, which is 1 state, and if I get J and K as 1, 0, when J is 1, K is 0, I'm retaining in the state 1 only, that is this only. So, irrespective of 0, 0 or 1, 0, my output is 1 and I'm remaining in the same. And the last one, that is 1, 1. When it is 1, 1, that is J1, K1, and if my present state is B, which I call it as 1 state, when both JK are 1, 1, my output should be complement, right? If it is 1, it becomes 0. And which is the 0 state I'm saying? This is the one, okay? And you can see that whatever the state machine that we just drew is similar to this, okay? If the state A, which I call it as a zero state, and this is one state. Okay. If I am in present state, which is a zero state, if I get 0, 0 or 0, 1, I will remain in the same state because output is remaining zero. Okay. If not, if it is 1, 0 and 1, 1, since output changes, I have to move from present state 0 to next state 1 because this is the state with 1. Then we have to evaluate with respect to B, and this is how exactly it moves on. Okay, so this is the explanation of JK flip-flop Mealy state machine, in which the output not only depends upon the present state but also depends upon on which, in which particular state it is. Okay, now we'll come to the Moore state machine. Okay, so here in Mealy we couldn't explicitly say that within the circle, that is A is a zero state. I can't tell that. For our understanding, we have this. But here we have mentioned, when I say a JK flip-flop, either JK flip-flop can have zero, store zero, or whose output may be zero, or it may be one. So in Moore, I will mention the outputs within the variable name, okay, within the circle. That is, I have two states again, one state with the variable A, and that state, in that state, if I'm in that state, the output will be zero. If it is B, I define the output to be something like one. Okay, I have state one and state two, and state one variable is A, and if the state, in the state A, I immediately say that if I'm in state A, its output is zero. So now my output of Moore depends only on the present state. See, if I'm in present state A, then my output is zero. If I'm in state B, my output is one. I least bother about what is the input. But no doubt the entire system requires inputs. It is not that we don't require inputs, but with respect to output, if I see, Mealy output depends upon the present input and the present state, whereas in Moore output depends only on the present inputs. Okay, this is what we'll try to see now again. Okay, so as I said, two states, one state A with the output zero, explicitly defined. So in Moore, in the variable within the circle, you will be finding the output. In the Mealy, you won't find the anything apart from the variable name. Okay, and one more, which is one. And you may ask me, why I am choosing only two state variables, A and B? Why two states? Because I am interested in getting the state machine for JK flip-flop, one JK flip-flop, and one flip-flop can have two states. Yes, zero state or one state. One state for one variable and another state for another variable. And that's why we have two states, A with output zero and one. Now, if this is my present state, and if my J and K values are 0, 0, when J and K are 0, 0, if my present state is this, okay, if my present state is this, okay, when J and K are 0, 0, output is previous, right? And if this is the previous with the output 0, the next state also remains the output 0. So that's why I retain in the same state. Or, okay, I won't use the bar there. Okay, I use something like, if not this, okay, if it is J0K1, again my output is zero. That's why I've written in the same thing. Okay, if it is 1, 0 or 1, 1 JK inputs, then I will move to the next state, which is B, because there the output is one. This is what, when 1, 0 and 1, 1, my JK is, output becomes 1, because when it is 1, 0, it is set. When it is 1, 1, it is the complement of previous. From here, I am moving to here. For this, the previous is 0, that's why it becomes 1. Okay. And if I'm in state B, which is with the output 1, if it is 0, 0, I will remain in the same state. J and K both 0, 0, because my next state follows the previous, right? If this is the next state, and the for the next state previous is this. Why? Qn doesn't change with respect to Qn plus 1, or Qn plus 1 doesn't change with respect to Qn. It will just follow this. If it is 0, 1, it will go to the state A. Y means output is defined 0 here. Okay, when the JK is 0, 1, if I'm in state B with the output 1, the next state will be 0. That is, the output will be 0. So that's why I'm going to 0. If it is 1, 1, 1, 0, I remain in the same state. Why? My present state is B and its output is 1. And JKR is 1, 0. When J is 1, K is 0, my output is 1. So that's why I'm remaining in the same state with this. If not, if it is 1, 1, if I'm in state B with output 1, and this becomes the present input for this, okay? For the next state, output becomes 0. That's why I'll be in this, okay? So this is what I'm having with respect to the JK flip-flop. One is the Mealy and the Murray. Easy to identify the Murray is within the variable name, we have the output defined. Okay? So this is what I have. Okay, next, we'll try to see SR flip-flop in the similar fashion. Okay, again, when I say SR flip-flop, it is also flip-flop. Again, it we can store 0 or 1. That is what I have. Okay, so again, Mealy sequential machine or the Murray sequential machine or a state machine. Okay, S naught is one of the state variable, and I have one more state with a variable name S1. Okay, this is the state. State 1, state 2, with state 1 variable S0 and with state 2 variable S1. Okay. Again, S0, I take it as something like a 0 state. S1, I will consider it to be something like a 1 state. This is for our understanding. Okay. If I'm in state S0 and if that is a 0 state, if I get 0, 0, again, I will be remaining in the same state similar to my JK. If it is 0, 1, I'll remain in the same. If it is 1, 0, then I will have. And 1, 1 condition doesn't come in SR flip-flop. That's why we don't have 1, 1 with respect to S and R. Okay? That's it. And if I'm in S1 and if this state, I call it as a 1 state. If I get 0, 0, I remain in the same state. If it is 0, 1, I move to the next state. Okay? I think one more is missing. What is that? 0, 0, no change. 0, 1. It is going to this 1, 0, have to be in the same state, okay? 1, 0, with 1, okay? This is what is missing. And here also it is 1, 0, sorry. Okay, that's it. This was missing, please add this one, okay? So, if I'm in S0, which I call it as a 0 state, if I get 0, 0, no change, that's why I'll be in the same state. If it is 0, 1, you can see that output, there is no change. That's why I remain in the same state. If it is 1, 0, my output changes. So that's why I move to the next state. If I'm in S1, if it is 0, 0, no change. If it is 1, 0, again, output is 1. That's why I remain in the state S1 because this is a 1 state. And if it is 0, 1, I move to the next state. This is about the SR flip-flop. Coming to the Murray state machine of SR flip-flop, we have something like this. S0, we define the output as 0. That means if I'm in state S0, its output is 0. If I'm in state S1, its output is 1. This output depends upon the present state of S1. This output depends upon S0. Again here, if I'm in present state S0, which is the 0 state, if I get 0, 0 or 0, 1, I remain in the same. If not, if it is 1, 0, I go to the next state, that is S1, whose output here is 1. Only when S is 1, R is 0, my output becomes 1. And since I was in this state with the output 0, I moved to this because output has changed to 1. Similarly, if I'm in S1, if it is 0, 0 or 1, 0, I remain in the same state. If it is 0, 1, my output should change to 0. That's why I'm moving from present state S1 with the output 1 to the next state S0 with output 0. Okay. So this is about the Mealy and Murray sequential networks, example with respect to JK flip-flop and SR flip-flop, the definition and the example with respect to the Mealy and Murray. To summarize this Mealy and Murray, these are the two types of sequential machines we have. Mure and the Mile. In Mure, output depends only on the present state or the current state, synchronous with the current state. Whereas in the Mile, output not only depends upon the present state, but also depends upon the present input. Okay. So if you see any state machine of Mile or Mure, okay, you can see that differentiation is in the Mure, my output is defined within the state. That's why we call output depends upon the present state. Output depends upon the present state. Indirectly, they are depending upon the inputs. That's a different case. Okay. Okay. So this is all about your sequential networks. In the next section, we'll take up two examples and see how exactly we move ahead in terms of sequential machines. Thank you.